was our God's mercy and love. Lord Jesus, you raise us up to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood. Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your peoples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation for anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God, yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me.
Just as the Father knows me, I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Lately, I've been studying the Divine Comedy. This is an ancient or spiritual text who was written in the 13th century by an Italian poet. And it's been recommended by Bishop Barron and Pope Francis, so it's in line with Catholic teaching. But anyway, one of the things that it discussed was pride. And was saying how, imagine a child baptized in infancy. And then he said, that child will be remembered just as much as you will in 1,000 years. And that's really true. You know, and I think about all the stuff that I've done in my, whether my homilies, whether it's a pastoral initiative, whether it's doing something on buildings, and in 1,000 years, no one will care. And then I started to ratchet it back and said, okay, well, what about 100 years? What would they care if I, in 100 years? And again, no. But what, no one knows what happened 100 years ago in this parish. And then I was like, okay, about 50 years. And then I started going down lower and lower and lower. It's like, what am I actually asking? What I'm actually asking is, how much do I need people to remember me to satisfy my ego, to satisfy my pride? And that's not just me who does this. People are members of the church, you know. I mean, this is my church. And they're very involved and give generously, but on the end, eventually they'll die or move, and they'll no longer be their church. Even if you're a family where you have children, I mean, you know that is better than I do, that when they turn into teenagers, then they got a mind of their own, they're no longer yours. And so if they're not yours, who are they? In the end, it's Jesus Christ. He is truly the Good Shepherd. It is all that we know that not only just on an intellectual level, but on a heart level, knowing that it's all there for Christ. That we are Jesus Christ. Everything belongs to Him. This church, my life, this parish, everything belongs to Him. And the reason why it belongs to Him is because He's risen from the dead. I mean, if He died and didn't go up, then He'd be just like any one of us. I mean, in 1,000 years, might not be remembered. But because He lives and moves, He's still there, leading and guiding us. And so indeed, if He's a good shepherd, then what are we? Because in the end, if it's not ours, are we like that hired man who cares nothing for the sheep? Are we hired? And I think the difference that separates between the hired and those who are sharing the shepherdship of Jesus Christ is our love. Are we willing to lay down our life for the sheep? Are we willing, whatever sheep that is, whether it's our job, whether it's our church, whether it's our family, whatever our sheep is in our life, it is up to us to give our lives over in imitation of the one who gave his life over for us. And so therefore, if we love, then we are shepherd. But not only that, to give praise and thanks to the one who actually is our true shepherd, Jesus Christ. Not to take a hired man or take the glory on his own. Look at what I achieved. Look at everything I've done. But instead to give God the glory. The greatest example of this is in the first reading with Peter. Peter goes and cures this cripple. And so this cripple is jumping up and down and all excited. And then
Peter could have told him, well, you got to be sure to take care of yourself because I want you alone for a long time so everybody I can point to and say, hey, there's the cripple I cured. You know, we don't even know what happened to that cripple. We only know that he got cured. And when he got cured and everybody stands around Peter, he doesn't say, look what I did. Instead, he gives God praise and glory. He attributes it all to Jesus Christ. Peter was a good shepherd. We can be good shepherds. An imitation of the one true shepherd, Jesus Christ, who has given us everything. May we have take care of those sheep that are under our care with love, knowing to give God the glory.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, for all things visible and invisible, but only in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, life from life, true God from true God, begotten not made, without substantial power, through whom all things were made, for us men and for our salvation.
Petitions that are offered to your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, through that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
The Lord has sacrificed your hands for the praise of the Lord Jesus, our Lord and all his
O Lord, grant that we may always find delight in these passive mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Those give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with passive joy, every land, every people exalts your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they apply. Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood. Of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. May become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make with us an eternal life. especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, of all the saints, of whose constant intercession and presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your glorious church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, and our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your home. Listen to the prayers of this family, whom you summon before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleased that you have your best in this life, give kind events into your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ the Lord, whom we destroy the world, all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Take away the sins of
kind shepherd, look upon your flock, and be pleased to settle on eternal pastures, the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. A few announcements. As part of the National Eucharistic Revival, our parish will be hosting two solemn processions with the Blessed Sacrament through the streets of Collinsville this summer. The first will be on Sunday, June 2nd, the Feast of Corpus Christi, following the 10:30 Mass. The second, on Monday, July 8th at 1 p.m., with the bishops of Springfield and Belleville participating. To participate in either or both processions, please sign up at the table by the welcome desk. More information can be found in the bulletin. The Knights of Columbus are hosting their Queen of Hearts raffle on Thursday evenings each week at O'Hara. Tickets will be sold between 6 p.m. and 7:45 p.m. with the drawing at 8 p.m. We'll note that the ad in this week's bulletin about the Queen of Hearts raffle was from a previous year and was included by mistake. We apologize for the confusion. An accurate flyer can be found at the welcome desk. The school spring raffle kicks off this weekend. Tickets are $20 each. Forms are available at the welcome desk. The grand prize is $3,000 cash.